You feeling good?
Yeah, it's a long shot, so it's going to be a cracker shot. Either.
Yeah, it's the one. Slowly keep coming up.
Oh, yeah, 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 yeah! Oh.
Yeah, mate.
Nice one, mate.
There's heaps, bro. Nice. There's heaps.
Well, you just know that you're in for an awesome trip when your trip starts in a helicopter. But when your helicopter is taking off from a place like Queenstown and you're heading up into the hills, like this country right here, you know it's going to be extra special.
Oh, there's got to be no better way to travel, really. Oh, look, is that dusting of snow fairly new, is it?
Yeah, by last night, any snow for you. You see any deer yet?
No, but...
I've seen quite a few.
Have you?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, you see, you will. Tell you what, if there was marlin in this lake, I'd just about move here.
I reckon this year could be the best spot. We saw a lot of shimmy here the other day.
Oh mate, this is amazing. This looks amazing.
Up the mountain there, Dave.
Oh, mate, the elusive chamois. Not so elusive if you've got a mate at Heliworks. He can bring him right to you. There you go, see? Another good reason why you come in with a helicopter. Mate, that is awesome.
Thank you very much, mate. This is amazing. I mean, check out where we are. We're in the high country above Lake Wakatipu. We've flown in here, we've got rifles, we've got our fishing gear, but we've also got tents, sleeping bags, and some extra warm winter woolies because we're going to be staying up here for the next couple of days, and this is going to be our base. It's kind of like Man vs. Wild, really, isn't it? Except we're not going to pretend that there's not a film crew here, and I probably won't be drinking any of my own urine either. This is awesome!
With the chopper now departed, the beauty and tranquility of this spot has really struck me, and I'm now able to appreciate why this high country calls out to so many Kiwi outdoorsmen, and I'm eager to make the most of my time here, so we quickly set up camp and head off on foot.
Well, now that we've set up camp, we're making our way up even higher, up to the snow line, and what we're looking for is one of New Zealand's most elusive wild game animals. The chamois.
So, what exactly are we looking for, Dan, when we're looking for these chamois in the hills?
Well, pretty much up where we are now, there's very few deer kicking around, so you'll see the chamois will be slightly different colour this time of year. They're sort of quite a grey colour.
Are we just relying on sort of spotting them before they spot us?
Yeah, ultimately, like, their vision is their number one sort of sense where they'll get onto a hunter, but they'll come down sort of through evening onto some of these faces and start feeding.
I've had a lot of hunters tell me, I mean, you yourself were saying that, you know, to about a hunter, a chamois in country like this is something pretty special. I mean, what is it that's so special about the chamois?
Well, yes, basically, you know, they're living in an environment where it's challenging for the hunter. They're in their element, and you pretty much get up here and you've got to have all the gear and you've got to have the legs to go with it.
And I mean, exactly what sort of an animal are they? I mean,
I think they're actually from the antelope family, and they're, you know, they're dispersed through sort of the French Alps, and here in New Zealand they're actually classified as a pest. So while they're beautiful and recognised as such from hunters and people who actually get up into this country, while they're classified as a pest, the government sees them as a negative value, and you just can't manage something that's labelled a pest.
Well, it's a pretty special pest that'll get people coming from all around the world and chartering helicopters and stuff to come into this beautiful country. Although I think this beautiful country's got a lot to do with it.
Right there, come here, come over here. Just on that scree, just on the scree there. See it there?
No.
On the scree, walking on the scree.
Do you know? I see him.
Okay, just remember how sensitive that trigger is.
Okay.
Get in there, just left.
To the big boulder, yeah.
See him in the scope there?
I got him in the scope, he's looking at us.
Yeah? Okay, you ready?
Yeah.
I'm gonna wind this in.
Yeah.
Still see him?
Yeah, man, I've got it right on his shoulder
okay.
right now.
Yeah, you just, I'll shut the bolt, okay? Just okay. take your finger off that trigger.
Yeah.
And then you just squeeze when you're ready.
I've got his bum at the moment, will I wait?
Just wait, yeah. Okay, when you're ready. Oh, you went high.
That felt good too.
Okay, just wait.
High, wait.
Just aim on its lower quartile when it stops. That was 249, quite a big buck. That was just a lone buck. Must have just gone over its backbone, did it?
Oh, everything felt good, mate.
Now, he doesn't know where we are, so if we come over onto this next spur, he could be just climbing up one of those bluff faces beyond. He'll try and get a bit of elevation.
Hey, Dan, there's some animals moving up on the hill.
Oh, is there? How far up? Down low? Oh, yeah, there's a few of them there.
They're onto us, are they?
Yeah, but they'll only climb into one of those bluffs. So pretty much, Matt, they've gone up there, they've been disturbed, but they've just climbed up to a spot where they pretty much feel that they're safe. I fear that when we get up there that they may have bluffed themselves, so you might get another shot.
When you say bluff themselves, they can't go anywhere.
Well, they can always climb over, but I think that sort of curiosity will get the better of them, and they quite often stand out on the outcrops and look down and sort of just survey the territory.
Okay, well, let's get going.
You feeling good? Yeah, it's a long shot, so it's going to be a cracker shot. Yeah. Yeah, that's the one. Slowly keep coming up. Oh, yeah. Oh.
Oh. Yeah, mate.
Nice one, mate.
There's heaps, bro. Oh. There's heaps.
Oh, we've spotted another chamois further up this gully. We've just got to move closer to get within range. It's a little bit far, particularly with this wind. It's really funneling down this gully. Now where am I looking? I haven't even seen it yet, mate.
Yeah, hang on. Tuck the gun into it if you can, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Okay. Look right up into the middle of that bluff.
The grassy bit?
Hang on. Okay, have a look. Go to that grassy knob and then just slowly go up into the bluffs, into the rocks. You see an animal there.
Oh, he is moving up.
See it?
Yep. He's standing nice now, he's looking straight at us.
Okay, see if you can find him in the scope.
Okay.
Now with this shot, you want to be aiming just bang on him, okay?
Okay, bang on him.
Yeah, you're looking genuinely in the right spot.
Yeah, mate, just above that grassy knob, there's a rock, right? Right behind it? Oh, I see him, yeah. I've got him now.
See that grey one walking?
Yeah, and he's side on at the moment?
Yeah, just wait for it, he'll come around.
His head's behind a rock, he's going behind a rock.
There's another one to the left, but it's a very young one, and a bigger one on a rock to the left.
Oh yeah, I see there's a big one up on top now.
How still do you think you are? You feeling good?
There's a little bit of movement there.
Okay, let's get something. It's a long shot, so it's going to be a cracker shot to get it. Okay, just wait for him to turn.
I've got it right on his shoulder now.
Okay, you do what you have to do. Oh, great shot, mate.
Oh, got him!
Beauty. Look at him come down.
That was miles away. Look, he's coming down, Dave.
That was a cracker, eh?
Cheers, bro.
That was a cracker shot. That was 312 metres.
312 metres. Three rugby fields. Uphill, crosswind, snow in my eyes. And the only thing is that he didn't have a gun. Otherwise, it would have been near on impossible. Well, this is where we'll find out just how far away it is. We've got to climb up there and claim our kill, and it's a long way up. You can see from way up here that the chamois's fallen. We've tracked him down and he's just stopped just before this bluff, so not too far to go now. We can have a close-up look. Well, there you go. That's the first chamois I've actually laid my eyes on, well, except for through a scope. There's not a real big target, eh? You know?
No, they're not big. They're not big through the chest. Nothing like those big stags you were looking at.
No, not from way down there. But, I mean, neat looking animal and an antelope, you say. So, we can eat some of this, can we?
Oh, most definitely, yeah.
Yeah?
Bit of a favourite old marinade and Yeah. You'll be loving it, mate.
Yeah, bit of wild mountain tucker, you know. Aside from providing us with a fantastic bit of wild game, you know, you certainly enjoy your meat more when you've been able to experience this to get it. And I've got you and your team at Big River Safaris
to thank for that.
And I've got the chamois to thank, of course, as well, because, you know, it's the animals that have ultimately brought us here to experience this high country hunting, and it's stunning. It really is. Right, time to carve this thing up, and you don't have to watch that bit. And back to camp before dark too. Brilliant.
Yeah, cook up a brew, I reckon.
You know that first one I missed it on purpose, eh? You know, like to build the drama, and it was way too close.
Yeah.
Yep, looks like a good day for fishing, so best we get packed up and wait for our ride to pick us up. Oh, and have a cup of tea. You beauty. Oh yeah. Tastes so much better out here.
Within minutes of departing Mount Nick Station, the Heliworks chopper soon had us scouting out the Greenstone River for a place to touch down and cast a line.
Well, I mean, look at this. This is yet another stunning location. And as you can tell, we've got a river here. I've got one of these contraptions, which means we're going fly fishing for trout. I've only ever done it once before, but I've had fantastic fun doing it. And I don't see why this should be any different, in fact. Probably going to be better. Now, other than my inexperience, another thing we've got going against us is there's been a lot of rain up in the hills, so the river's flowing fast and it's dirty. So what we'd ideally like to do is sight fish, you know, wear your polarized shades, spot the fish, put a cast up in front of it and see if we can entice it to take that fly. Well, Dan's sort of working his way upstream, seeing if he can spot a fish. I'm actually going to reacquaint myself with this fly fishing gear. And it's probably a good thing, because if he spots one, I'd much rather get a few practice casts in.
Yeah, I found a fish, perfect catching position.
Dan's gone and spotted a fish up there, and he reckons it's in perfect catchable position, although I'm not sure if he's seen me cast yet.
I don't know if the camera will pick it up. Right there.
Yeah.
See him there now? He's just going out. No, he's feeding hard. Yep, he's just gone left now.
Yeah, okay.
It's just that wind, eh? Hang on, just see him there? So you can see him? Just.
Yeah, I see him.
Yeah.
And you reckon go to just to his right, eh?
Yeah, go right of him, yeah.
Just need to wait for this gust though, yeah?
See him there now?
Yeah, I see him. I'm just waiting for the wind. Oh, the wind that time, it's never going to go anywhere.
Nah.
That's right. Now what I've got to be aware of with this trout feeding upstream is if I lay this fly line in front of it, it's very visible. So it's going to see it, spook the fish, my chance is over. Now, what's compounding the fact that I'm not very good at casting or very experienced is I've got a wind wanting to blow my fly line this way, so we're really having to wait and cast in between gusts.
Yeah.
Moved away deeper then?
Yeah, I think that scared him, to be honest.
Well, given that it's really hard to spot any trout here, I'm just using where you'd think a fish would be sitting in this eddy up against this bank here, perhaps picking up some nymphs and bugs that are coming down the stream, and I'm just sort of trying to duck out of the wind. It's given me so much trouble. And just casting and letting that fly flow down the stream.
Yeah, that's the one. Just slowly keep coming up. Oh, yeah. Oh. Did he take it?
No, I didn't feel a single touch, mate.
Oh, I didn't feel him. Oh, he just big flash, he came up. He must have been just following it up, and then he had sort of a crack at it.
I saw him, just didn't feel him touch.
That's our chopper.
Yeah, that's our chopper actually.
Oh well, off to the salty stuff then.
My first high country outing was a great experience, and soon we'll be on our way home. But before our midday flight departs, we're racing back out to the coast to see if we can get some crayfish to pack into our carry-on baggage. And besides, they're much better than trout.
Well, it's daybreak, and I'm sure it's going to be cold, but when there's crayfish calling, it's worth it.
Yeah, mate.
Nice one, mate.
There's heaps, bro. Nice. There's heaps. I'm going straight back to it. Cheer, mate.
Yeah, I'll
get him. Watch him, he's a feisty bugger. I had a bit of a punch up with that one. Oh, I've got to get my breath calmed down. There are so many crows down there. Like, okay,
calm down.
That's not going to be hard down there. Woohoo! That was the biggest one I could find there. Oh mate, there's some monsters. You can see with his defending claws, he's really, defending, I guess. That's six. Awesome. And that was unbelievable. Oh, mate, there's some monsters. Check it out.
A lot of the gear and techniques in this episode have changed. And of course, we've had countless more fishing adventures. So to catch up with the latest tips and techniques, as well as our latest fishing action, check out ultimatefishing.tv and download the Ultimate Fishing app, so wherever you go, you've got access to our entire catalogue of tips, rigs, techniques, and location information. And it's all available free at ultimatefishing.tv.